ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and everyone in between, this is a special Uncle Bosco presentation from Beer Week, San Francisco, a trip to the Pyramid Brewery. And a grossly overexposed intro.
Hey, how you doing?
Sometimes cheapness is funny.
So, here we go with the Pyramid Beer crew. I've never been overly impressed with Pyramid Beer, especially some of their newer stuff, especially the unfiltered stuff. Come on, guys. I make better unfiltered beer in my fucking basement. Okay. Oh, by the way, when I ordered my burger, ordered it well done, it came half raw. Thanks a lot.
You know, I'm not sure. We still did stick with the dry hop, so we didn't necessarily go out of the way to get seasonally fresh wet hops. We did dry hop it like we do with most of our beers, so okay. We didn't necessarily get it while it was in season.
And if you can hear it, here's the guy going out of his way to not describe to me the hop schedule. I don't even think he knew what he was talking about.
I'm sure that Hallertau is actually really difficult to get nowadays, so I can tell you how quickly we were able to get it, you know, when it was in season.
Huh.
Hello there.
Interesting. Okay.
So the only good thing I can say about Pyramid is if you've never been to a brew pub before, go to the Disneyland of brew pubs called Pyramid. You'll get an adequate beer, and hopefully they'll cook your burger.
Well, you might be able to get away.
Can you tell me how this was hopped? What kind of hop?
Okay, here we go. This is a really good beer, EJ Fair. It's a little tiny brewery. They only had two brews on tap that night. One of them was an old traditional ale, real heavy on the malt. I like a good malty beer lately. It's very light on the hops. And it came in at about 7.75 is what they indicated on the ABV. The IBU were about almost nothing really. But this guy over here helped me a lot. It's real traditional, more like an alt than anything else. The only difference between that and an alt is they're just calling it an old style ale, which is basically what the hell an alt is. So there it is, EJ Fair Brewing. Probably the best traditional ale I had that night.
Purely Cascade, all through Cascade.
And the, damn, I can't think of the other one.
Cheers.
We give you a number, it's kind of, you know, we can fudge our computer program a little
so
bit.
So you whirlpool the hot.
So after flame out.
Okay. I'm a home brewer, so okay, I'm...
So after flame out, okay. We throw a big charge of hops in there.
Okay.
All right. This is Altamont Beer Works. Really nice California, really good example of California beers. Little bit over hopped, little bit over the top on just about everything. The double red IPA he was talking about, they call it ganja juice, has nothing to do with ganja or juice, but it's a really, really good double red IPA. The IBUs are not overwhelming, and probably the best California traditional over-the-top kind of IPA I had that night.
That's good. Nice. Oh, like the Trumer. Interesting. That's real interesting.
And no beer festival would be complete without a stop at the Buffalo Bill Brewery Girls. Jeez, and this was the only booth in the whole damn place that was giving away a decent souvenir. Huge, huge, huge stainless steel bottle openers. Hey, And the alimony ale is really, really smooth. It's not as hopped up as you'd think. They call it an IPA. I don't think it's an IPA. It tastes more like a pub bitter to me. But they call it an IPA, so alimony IPA. That's Buffalo wild. Bill. Hey, girls.
Yes, he did. We passed away recently.
Next stop is Ale Industries. Only reason I really stopped here is because one of his beers was called California's Gold. The one on the right there. Yeah. Dedicated to Huell Hauser. He passed away not too long ago. He did a show called California's Gold. And boy, he was just the nicest person you could ever want to meet. Golly. And, Huell's no longer with us, but we can brew a good beer. This guy at Ale Industry was doing some wacky stuff with his beer, so, you know,
give me a little bit, of a rinse.
Moving right along.
Take a look at it. Let me see if I can find my damn cards. But if you go to my YouTube channel and look for Uncle Bob.
Now we come to, I think, of what is pretty much a pinnacle of what this festival could offer. It's a 14-month-old Grand Cru. This beer is heaven. Grand Cru. Very dark, very fruity, very much like a Trappist or an Abbey Ale, but much darker, much more complex. It's up around 8 or 9%. I can't remember what he was saying, but it really doesn't taste like it. It's an interesting process too, because at certain points during the fermentation, this is what he's describing to me, they would split this out and ferment it a little bit separately to where they had three components separately fermenting. And then at some point, before the conditioning, they'd blend it all back together and then stick it in the keg. And they used real kegs, real oak kegs. This stuff smells like what a really good open whiskey smell would taste like. It's just beautiful. That comes from the oak. And the beery qualities of it will just flatten you. You get a bottle of this stuff and share it with a friend like a bottle of wine. It is that good. This gets some kind of unspecified award that we do not even know of at this point in time. We must consult Uncle Bosco about this. This is probably the best beer, the best crafted beer I had that entire evening. Black Diamond Brewery, the Grand Cru from Black Diamond Brewery. Get it, enjoy it, it's great stuff. Well, that's about it for the beers for that night. I'm going to leave you with some snapshots and a little bit of footage from the tour that we took inside the brewery. They said no pictures. Get the hop vines out of your posteriors, guys. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and everyone in between, thanks for watching, and look forward to the next episode of Uncle Bosco's Beer House. See ya!
No flash photography or cell phone use of any sort. If you're wondering why, since it's a fire hazard.
Bullshit, and you know it. Thank you.
issues.
The Zen Cat Network, where cheapness is king.